Howdy, and welcome to Reeves Reviews, the show where I watch and talk about every theatrically released movie featuring Keanu Reeves. This week, we're talking about The Prince of Pennsylvania. Now, I think Roger Ebert put it best in his review when he said, "It forces realistic characters into an absurd plot, and expects us to accept the plot because we believe in the characters." Fortunately, I am not out here competing with Roger Ebert. If you wanted to read his review, you would go do it. Instead, you are watching a transgender animation student talk about Keanu Reeves movies. But you know what? I am a transgender animation student. And for one of my classes here at Online Art School, I've been reading a lot of books by and about LGBT people. And my professor is always asking us, you know, what makes this a queer narrative? And folks, The Prince of Pennsylvania is a queer narrative. Keanu plays Rupert Marshetta. Rough name, but he's a smart suburban teen with a punky attitude. Another character I strongly relate to. The character's queer vibes are acknowledged by the film.
Bad! You asshole!
Not that every person ever called a homophobic slur is gay, but in film that's always going to be an intentional choice. Now, I'm not saying that Rupert is specifically a gay character or a trans character or any other specific identity. Instead, like Bastard out of Carolina's Bone, his queerness is defined by an exclusion and otherness from the straight world. Underneath the convoluted plot, this movie is about Rupert conflicting with his parents and rebelling against the straight world generally. And when I say straight world, I'm not talking just about heterosexuality, but monogamy, the nuclear family, rigid gender roles, etc. Rupert's dad often comments on how his son falls short of himself, and influences him to behave in a more manly way and follow in his own footsteps. This conflict between the two of them is what spurs the ridiculous series of events this movie calls a plot. Tellingly, his mom points out that Rupert isn't like his father. He's a new type of guy for a new time. The 80s, a time of peace, prosperity, and gender nonconformity. The narrative of a gender nonconforming teen outsider butting up against the system is so common. From Sing Street to Enola Holmes to Flying, which I talked about on the show before. And even when I don't love the movies themselves, these characters almost always work for me because I just find it really relatable. Now, in all the films I just listed, the nonconformist has a straight love interest, so maybe not everyone sees this trope the same way I do. And I know not everyone who was rebellious as a teen grew up to be both gay and trans. But personally, I can't separate my teenage rebellion from my queerness. And hey, I would say neither can writer and director Ron Niswanner, or Niswanner, who is an openly gay man and also wrote the Academy Award-winning Denzel Washington starring movie Philadelphia,
which was apparently one of the first mainstream Hollywood films to acknowledge HIV/AIDS, homosexuality, and homophobia.
Which I really want to see now. You know, I wrote the analysis part before I googled the director, and I'm pretty proud of myself for seeing something that might actually be there. But, you know, I would be right regardless of his own identity, because that's how media analysis works.
And since he hasn't tweeted since 2018, guess you'll have to live with my interpretation. Thanks for watching.